Sanchez down the wing. Vinches, it's a good kick. But it's well taken by Dyson. He gets out of it and gives it to Wicks in cover defence. And Wicks in the left wing three quarter over this side. He's lost possession. Dan has got a chance for Wakefield. If they move the ball about. Getting tough. Turner, going to be a drop by Fox. And he's dropped it. Second this afternoon, two drop goals. 7-3. 18 minutes left for play, and Wakefield leading 7-3. Last 20 minutes. Don't see many drop goals in this game, but those are valuable, and it's Wakefield who are going to try and make no mistakes. Seven, three, 4 points in it. One try, one goal, and that's 5 points. So just how close it is. Chance for Hurst. Hurst away, he's got one man to beat. If he beats him, he's in. He's not in front of it. He's in. He's in for the try. He's left. £1,500 for doing so. What a wonderful moment for him, and what a great try by this youngster from Leeds for Wakefield. And the prediction that the game was going to open into some scoring came just again. It was the right moment, and it's the kicker is Neil Fox, who scored all the points up to first try. 10-3. Long kick, it will come across, no goal. Well, 15 minutes left to play, and it's Wakefield with a 7 points lead. And the ball's got to be dropped off. Not, in other words, it's not going to go 10 yards, it's just going to pass the line of mark. Hence the two fellas standing on the mark, so he doesn't try any funny business. He goes, and Turner gets it. Ooh, Turner gets it. Wicks. Huddersfield won't give in. They'll keep going right to the end. Wakefield will have to. And well, again, it's a penalty. A penalty for Frank Dyson, and he's been told to kick a goal by Captain Thomas Smales. So can Dyson keep up his record of scoring in every cup round? And can he bring the margin to one of 5 points? Well, you can see the distance there, the 25 line, away up to the post. And you see where he placed the ball to get the distance. Not kicked the goal yet, Dyson. Push. pushes them off and goes on the goal. De Haas. Four cups is within their grasp. They've got to beat Huddersfield again to do so. And Brick preferred. 10-3, Wakefield Trinity, two tries, two goals, 10 points. Huddersfield, one try, 3 points. 12 and a half minutes left for play as Brick tries to make the break. Again to Hurst. Now Hurst. Pull him back in. There you go. Oh, yeah, not going to allow anybody to go out of play if they can help it. That means losing chance of certain possession. Well, who does he want on? Oh, he wants the Wakefield trainer on. It's for Brian Briggs' nose again, I think. Is he winded? Ah, it's down the back of his neck. Ah, that's water. Out of the fire, rather, with you've got to go to such men as Wicks. The runners now in the team, I feel, it's no good concentrating on the forwards, at least only for creating positions. Ten points to three. 10 minutes left. Sensational things have happened before in cup finals. Green. Well tackled by Hurst. Got a play the ball. Good. Oh. Mill interception. No. Ramsden saved it. Each team, you know, coming up very quickly. As soon as the pass is made, or even before, they're anticipating that they're shooting out before the gun goes. Now then, you must move it across, Huddersfield, for Wicks to have a run. He's not had a run yet. Thomas Mayall starts to get it to him, he does. Halfway line. Huddersfield have got 9 precious minutes to pull this game out. Clark. Smales, and they are moving it around. Moving the ball about more now. They realise what they've got to do. But Wakefield's defence is still very, very good. Wakefield, this All Yorkshire White Rose final. and it's amazing the little distances that players allowed to go. The tackling is position is so good. Now this is Huddersfield's chance. It's a, oh, an interception by Hurst. And Fox, and I think Fox might score. Got something in his eye, and it wasn't a piece of dust either. If it is, well, Paddy Armour's gonna have to come and take something out. Yeah, that might be black tomorrow. Well, the Fox will take the kick and goal, and it will be 12 points if he does kick it. The 25 line there, the goalposts, distance, and the kicker, Frank Dyson, the kicker at the other end, Neil Fox, number four. Wakefield Trinity dropped two goals already, kick to place, kick, and it's hit the post, chance for Haywood. I don't think it's quite recovered from his leg injury. Wicks, can Wicks do something sensational? Well, there's plenty of action, plenty of incident, and it's Bowman to try to make the break. 10-3, and we've got left for play just about 6 minutes. Wakefield will be happy to keep Huddersfield in this position. I don't mean only in the scoreboard, but I mean on the field of play. Now, there's a Huddersfield player in between there. Smales. Well taken, Clark. Haywood. Well, the Huddersfield backs are likely coming more into the game. There was their only chance now to move it about. Move it about means moving the ball about. 25 line. Two players having a bit of a chat to one another. One from each side. I'm sure they're not exchanging complimentary greetings either. Who can we get into the middle? Slevin. Oh, it's a nice one. It's a nice one. It's a Bowman. He's got to go the other way. He's gone the wrong way. Well, that could have been a sensational try for Huddersfield if Wicks could have got at it. But Wakefield are covering well. 5 minutes left for play, and it's Wakefield Trinity 10, Huddersfield 3. Hurst is limping, and Huddersfield are attacking. They haven't got the ball. Gary Round. Which way they're going to throw it? Safe fullback, Round. One of the Wakefield tourists, Jack Wilkinson, another Wakefield tourist. Turner to Williamson. And Wakefield will now do a Huddersfield. They'll keep it amongst the forwards to gain yards. Long one. They haven't done. Gary Round. Derek Turner looks fully recovered from his earlier injury. Briggs. Good forward, Brian Briggs. This is Huddersfield right bang on the Wakefield line. 4 minutes left, and it's a penalty to Huddersfield. Now, will they have an up and under? Will they have a shot at goal? It's Tommy Smith. Ireland is looking for the touchline side, and David Valentine, the coach, has signaled us 5 minutes, so it's an up and under. We could have told him that there's four. Frank Dyson, and the first out of the ball goes up in the air. It's a chance for Hutt. No, Wakefield saved it. Well, it's the up and under is saved by Wakefield. 10-3. He's going to leg injury, however it's play still on. 25, there's Hurst with Paddy Armour, the coach. Well, just minutes left now, 2.5 minutes in fact. Wakefield's third cup of the season. If they've beat Huddersfield in this Challenge Cup, they've then got to play them in the Championship final. So it's just 2 minutes to go. Chance for Huddersfield to get the try. Haywood going up, but he's going into trouble. Going into trouble. Wakefield has got 12 men at the moment. Overlap. Extra man. Extra man. Green must go inside. Or Booth must. But again, this wonderful cover defense. Wakefield. Oh, there's a chance for Huddersfield. They must score now. They must score. Peter Unfield does. Must score. Moment. 2 tries each. 1.5 minutes to play. Well, can we get, is it going to be a sensational last minute effort by Huddersfield? They'll have 1 minute only to do it in. Frank Dyson, chance of a goal kick. Remember I said he scored in other rounds. He hasn't scored yet. He's got a chance. 10-6. It. 4 points in it. 60 seconds left for play. We make it. And Hurst is back on the field. There he is, limping. Well, those two drop goals of Neil Fox look like being most valuable. He'll give a long one. He'll give a long ball. Bree must try and run it out. Neat possession, Huddersfield. And Wakefield will now try to keep the last second of this game in this quarter of the field. Evan Dyson. Time. Oh, it's nearly an intercept, a knock-on. Well, we make it the injury time now is being put in. Oh, it's going to, they're going to score! No try. Yet. What did the referee give him? No, he's given a drop, given a scrum. Well, Poynton almost got a sensational try when the pass was dropped. And Neil Fox has dropped back here. If Wakes will get the ball, I won't be... Neil Fox, I'll guess, will have a drop of goal. Pick the neck out. Here, if Wakefield get it, we'll see what happens. They didn't get it clear enough. Is they're going to do, Neil Fox is going to have a drop, and he's dropped it. Well, and there goes the whistle for time with Fox. Drop goal to finish the match and make Wakefield winners of this Challenge Cup by 12-6. Well, it was quite a remarkable finish. Neil Fox, who has kicked, dropped three goals, dropped three goals, something probably unheard of in a Rugby League Challenge Cup final, certainly at Wembley. There he is, the kicker. And so it will be Derek Turner to lead the Wakefield team up to receive the cup. And Derek Turner to receive the cup. And waiting for the signal. Well, there's a very bright. There's the triumphant Wakefield side with a chance to do the four cup feat. Derek Turner, Neil Fox, get around the last wave. Well, Derek Turner doesn't give smiles easily away. Well, the presentation of the cup will be made by the Field Marshal, the Right Honourable, the Earl Alexander of Tunis. And it will be to Turner, Bill Fallowfield, Rugby League Secretary in the picture, and the chairman of Stuart Hatfield congratulates his captain. And there's a cup for you, viewers, especially for you to see. Thank you, Derek Turner. Keith Holliday, Fred Smith, Neil Dropkick Fox. That'll point in as the Fox boy. First, Wilkie, Jack Wilkinson, Alan Skeen, Jeff Oakes, Brian Briggs, Dennis Williamson, Ken Hurst, who got the try, and Jerry Round. And a very gallant, a very noble, a very well fought Huddersfield team. Thomas Mills, the captain. There's just goals in this result. Thomas Smales, Peter Ramsden, who these two got the tries. Smales first and now Peter Ramsden. Ken Bowman and veteran Ted Slevin. Don Close, the hooker. Aidan Breen, the winger. Leo Bull, right centre. Ray Haywood. Clark, second row forward, Mick Clark. Ken Noble. Harry Deaton, teenager, Mike Wicks, and Frank Dyson, who couldn't kick the goal he so much wanted, no doubt, today. And the referee, Mr. Dennis Davis, who I think had a very good game. He's controlled a very, very hard game exceptionally well. The Holland, the lineman. Well, there's the team who have now can still do this wonderful feat of winning four cups in one season. It's only been done three times. Turner, number 13, Wakefield, not unlucky. His feelings, no doubt, when he was injured early on, must have been wondering what that 13 jersey meant. But it's Derek Turner for the 2 years, 1960. He got the cup from Her Majesty the Queen at Wembley. Now he gets it again today, 1962 Rugby League Challenge Cup final. And on Monday week, he and number one, Jerry Round, you can see. Five of the Wakefield Trinity players will be touring the Great Britain Rugby League touring team, go to Australia a week on Monday, and amongst them will be the The Wakefield players want to take it to a special, their wives and girlfriends, and they're taking it specially to show them first. And I wonder then whether they'll do the usual lap of chase round. Well, yes, it's known at Wembley, I suppose, as the lap of honour, but the photographers are still wanting to take the picture. I wonder if they've got the top of the cup. I can't see who's got it. Ken Trail, the coach. Paddy next to the photographer, far one, and away they go on the run. Now, they must have been watching Spurs last week. They're doing it in relays, I would imagine. Gerry Round. Well, with about £75 in this win, and the energy still left. Success, no doubt, gives them a lot of energy and the excitement of success. Professional football is trained twice a week on a Tuesday and Thursday. Only evenings, by and large. What a tribute to their fitness. We won't forget Alan Huddersfield in this and a group of Wakefield supporters. Keith Holliday carrying the plinth. There's change over. Someone else is having a carry around. Firth and Hurst. Well, Wakefield's known as the Murray City. It'll certainly be Murray tonight. I should imagine on Monday when this team gets back. Fred Smith now the carrier. Dennis Williams coming in, number 12. Keith Holliday both hands full now. They'll have a meeting. Well, the crowd estimated here at 95,000. Certainly got their money's worth in a real ding-dong struggle that Huddersfield have played a very prominent part in. Neil Fox, and we hope to have my old friend David Coleman down there to have a word with somebody. And well, Neil Fox, I think, the kicker, Derek Turner, and Neil Fox are going to be the two men whom David's going to be talking to. Well, there's Derek, there's David Coleman, and there's our radio cameraman, and any second, David will be talking to them.